In order to get a sense of the electromagnetic action of the step-by-step switching equipment, we're going to follow a call through the step-by-step demonstration unit. We'll do this in slow motion, about 1/4 speed, then follow up with a normal speed version. We're going to place a call from the Beechwood 45789 telephone set to the Pennsylvania 65000 telephone set. The handset is removed from the telephone base. This allows the switch-up buttons to pop up, closing the loop through the telephone set. At the central office, this causes the calling telephone's line relay to operate. The operated line relay will cause a line finder to be selected and activated. It will find the calling line and connect it to the switching network. The line finder steps up vertically and rotates horizontally and stops when the wipers are connected to the calling line's terminal. When connected, the cutoff relay operates, which releases the line relay. The line finder is permanently connected to a first selector, and it now extends the calling telephone through to the first selector. The first selector's A relay operates over the loop through the calling telephone. First selector now returns dial tone, which can be heard through the telephone receiver. The caller dials the first letter of the called exchange, which is a P. At this point, the dial is about to begin its return. As the dial returns, it sends pulses to the central office. The selector responds to these pulses and acts to extend the calling telephone through to the next stage of the switching network, ready for the next letter or numeral to be dialed. The returning dial sends out 7 pulses. The A relay releases and reoperates 7 times in response to the dial pulses. The vertical magnet armature closes and opens 7 times in response to the A relay. The vertical pawl pulses up and down 7 times in concert with its armature, engaging the vertical ratchet teeth 7 times, thereby stepping the selector shaft upwards 7 positions. The selector wipers, being fixed to the shaft, move upward 7 positions, directly in line with the 7th level of the bank assembly. The previous 5 events, that is the dial returning, the A relay pulsing, the vertical magnet pulsing, the pawl pulsing, and the wiper stepping vertically upwards, are all depicted sequentially in the video for clarity. In actuality, all these events occur simultaneously. As soon as the returning dial comes to its rest position, the selector automatically begins to rotate the wipers across the dialed level, 7 in this example. It hunts for the first idle trunk path to the next selector. In the video, it finally finds an idle trunk on the 10th or last position on the level. The wipers are stopped and remain connected to the selected trunk. The selector trunk is connected to a second selector. The first selector extends the calling telephone through to the second selector. The second selector A relay operates over the loop through the calling telephone. As the call progresses through the 2nd to 6th characters in the call telephone number, the central office equipment activity is repetitive in nature. I'll just let you watch and enjoy the telephone dial and switching equipment sounds. The trunk is connected to a 3rd selector. The 2nd selector extends the calling telephone through to the 3rd selector. The trunk is connected to a 4th selector. The third selector extends the calling telephone through to the fourth selector. The trunk is connected to a fifth selector. The fourth selector extends the calling telephone through to the fifth selector. The trunk is wired to a connector. The fifth selector extends the calling telephone through to the connector. At this point, instead of rotating to hunt for a trunk, the connector waits for the last or the unit's numeral of the called telephone number to be pulsed. The connector follows the pulses, rotating the wipers across the terminals with the number of rotated steps equal to the number of pulses. The wipers stop on the terminal of the called telephone number. For the unit's numeral, the rotary magnet armature closes and opens 10 times in response to the pulses of the A relay. The rotary armature pawl pulses in and out of the teeth of the rotary ratchet 10 times, thereby rotating the connector shaft 10 horizontal steps. The wipers are fixed to the shaft and therefore rotate 10 steps along with the shaft. The wipers stop on terminal 00, the last two numerals of Pennsylvania 65000, which connects to the called telephone. The connector applies ringing current to the called telephone. When the call is answered, the connector stops the ringing and bridges the calling telephone through to the called telephone.
The number you have reached is
Pennsylvania 65000. Da 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 da. Hello, operator. Hello. Please don't keep me waiting to call Pennsylvania 65000.
Numbers I've got by the dozen. Everyone's uncle and cousin. But I can't live without buzzing. Pennsylvania.
Now we'll place the call again, this time just looking at the switch wipers in action at normal speed. Thank you. Well, I hope you found this video both educational and entertaining. If you did, be sure to watch for future Lenny the Phone Guy videos about the step-by-step telephone switching system. Thanks for watching.